addiction. It does not discriminate against age, sex, gender, ethnicity, or your background, who you are, or where you come from. It's one of those things, it just creeps up on you. You don't really notice it. And it's a plague that has spread from city to city, state to state, nation to nation. And it's a plague that has infected millions of people around the world. And once you're in that hole, it seems like it's impossible to get out of it. That is just a constant uphill battle. And you feel like you're losing, that you can't win, but you can. And there is light at the end of the tunnel. You are not what your parents may have been, or your uncles, or anybody in your family, whether they were a drug addict or a raging alcoholic. That is not you. That generational curse is broken, starting with you. Now, I'm telling you off of first hand, I battled it for years, and I didn't expect it. And, you know, I know what it feels like. It ate me alive inside. It ate me alive from the inside out. I had these goals, I had dreams, and I had aspirations. And I'm sure a lot of you do as well. But what comes first? The addiction. And the longer I fought it and was losing, the worse I felt inside. I knew that one day my time was going to come. And everything that I ever dreamed of, everything that I was passionate about, was eventually going to go to the grave with me. And it was painful. It was an emotional pain that I was causing upon myself. But I knew I had to do something, and it wasn't going to be easy. First off, it was taking the first step, knowing what the problem is, what you are struggling with, and then understanding why you are doing it. Whether it's to cover up a pain of past trauma, a coping mechanism to avoid facing the reality of life for what it is. But when you come down, there it is again. The problem is staring at you right in the face. And there it is again, the addiction, whatever it may be. And you can get out of it. And it's just by taking that first step, that leap of faith. And you have to tell yourself, you can and you will. And you have to think of your why. Why do you want to? And who are you doing it for? And I recommend first and foremost, you do it for yourself. Do it for your own well-being. And then if you have kids, you have a family, do it for them. It doesn't matter what people may have called you or judged you because of your mistakes. You can turn that around. Now, if I was able to do it, and it was hard, then anybody can do it. And I had to take the first step. And telling myself, never again. I will never pick up another beer. I will never sip another drop of liquor ever again for the rest of my life. And once I made it up in my mind, everything changed. And it was hard. It was a process. but I was able to do it. And I believe that there are healthy addictions. I took that and I transferred that into the addiction of self-development, self-growth, the addiction of bettering myself in every aspect of my life, physically, mentally, spiritually, and emotionally. I'm in the gym just about seven days a week now, and I'm healthier than I've ever been in my entire life at 31 years old, healthier than I've ever been in my 20s, and I feel great every day, and I don't miss those days of waking up feeling awful with a hangover. That guilt is no longer eating me alive inside, and even the thought of me going to the grave with my dreams and aspirations is no longer a thought. Now, I want you to take the first step. First and foremost, have a tight circle. Have a circle of people that support you, that are there for you. Because if I can do it, you can do it too. And believe, you have to believe in yourself. You have to want to make the change and start to become addicted to self-development, to self-growth, self-improvement, to becoming better each and every single day. Think about who you're doing it for and use that as your motivation, as your why. Why am I doing this? It's for my kid, it's for my son, it's for my daughter, it's for my wife, my husband, my mother, my father, whoever it may be. Use them, these people, as your fuel. When you wake up every day, it's the baby steps, the small changes. I'm not going to have that beer today. Instead, I'm gonna drink water. Your addiction does not own you. You own your life and you take control of your life. I am not going to inject that needle into my body today. Instead, I'm gonna do something better than that. I am better than that. I am better than my addiction. Instead, I'm gonna go to the gym. I'm gonna start doing cardio. I'm gonna start changing my circle of people who have been nothing but a bad influence and nothing but enablers to my addiction. Now it's time to unplug. Time to unplug. Anybody that's keeping you in your addiction, it's time to unplug. And your circle is going to get smaller, but the smaller your circle, the better it is. Now, I eliminated a lot of people out of my life, and you know what? It is for the better. And surround yourself with people that are going to encourage you, motivate you, and hold you accountable. And not let you look back. Now I want you to tell yourself one thing. I'm never looking back. It's done, that's my past. I'm only looking forward. And that's what I'm going to do for the rest of my days. And you tell yourself every single day, I'm going to work harder. I'm going to be a victor and not a victim. I'm going to become stronger mentally, spiritually, emotionally, and physically. My quality of life is going to improve. My family's life is going to improve. Tell yourself every single day that you can and you will make the change. Because if I can do it, and it was an uphill battle for me, and I struggled, and it hurt, and it was hard. But once I was able to face it, face the reality of life, of why I was doing what I was doing, and the long-term consequences, it's not worth it. And now, you know, I feel great. You know, I'm making videos that I hope to inspire other people. And, you know, I'm chasing my goals and I'm chasing my dreams. And it's never too late. I don't care how old you are, how young you are, what your circumstances is, if you're struggling with your addiction, whatever it may be, it is never too late to make the change. and you can. And now I'm just addicted to the self-development and my self-growth, and to continue to get better in every single day. I believe you can take that unhealthy addiction, whatever it may be, you can face that giant head on, and you can transfer that into something positive. Become addicted to self-improvement, to self-growth, to self-development every single day. Learn something new. Get better. Get healthier. Get stronger. Be more positive. Have more gratitude. And the quality of your life will improve. And you will be blown away by what you can accomplish. So I hope this helps somebody, inspire somebody out there that needed to hear this, because you are not alone. And I, like I said, I've been through it. I know what it feels like, but I know what it feels like to come out on top as well. And it's so much better when you come out of that. There is light at the end of the tunnel. You just have to want to make the change, and you have to believe in yourself, and you have to be patient. So this is for anybody that is battling addiction right now, that is struggling. You can do it. It is possible. But change starts with you putting one foot in front of the other. And it starts with the thought that you are going to make the change. But like anything, it has to come from the heart.